and circles, and maybe, of course, part of the circles, arcs, circles. One of the basic notions here is the broken line. I don't think I have to write all the definitions, they're written in the table. What is a broken line? Something like this. A, B, C, D, E is an example of a broken line. A, B, you denote it by the vertices. C, D, E is a broken line of 1, 2, 3, 4, four sides. They're called sides of a broken line. If the original and the terminal point coincide, the line is closed. Such lines called, I will draw a closed broken line. For instance, like this. A, this, this, maybe like this, and then like this. A, B, C, D, E. A, B, C, D, E, A. That's a closed broken line. It's also called the polygon. Let's try to be very specific. We will also call it usually a polygon when there is no self-intersection. No self-intersection. So, from this point A, B, C, D, E, A is a polygon. How many vertices are there? 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. It is 5 gon. Gonio is an angle. I think it also goes from Latin. Gonio is an angle. So how many angles are here? How many interior angles? 1 interior angle, 2, 3, 4, and 5. 5 interior angles. 5 sides respectively. Yes? Remember I mentioned proves it in a polygon, if there are 5 n angles, there are n sides, and vice versa. What else? A broken line can be convex if by extending one of the sides, the whole line will lie in one half plane. So this is a convex broken line. You can experiment with this. I'll experiment. For instance, I will extend this segment into a straight line. See the whole line? The whole line is in one position. Also, I will try to draw a similar line. Just like this. No, I didn't do much. I will just try to draw a similar line like this, like this, like this, and like this. This is a convex line. If I join the original point and terminal point B, C, D, E, I will receive a convex polygon. You can prove that this definition we applied for convexity coincides with the definition that we have given earlier, that any segment within the convex figure lies entirely in the convex figure. and there is a problem about it in the textbook, so please consider it and solve it. If you cannot solve, you can find the solution, I'm pretty sure. Either at the end of the textbook or in the solution manual. What's next? I hope I'm not missing things. And there's easy material, there is a danger that one can miss stuff. I think I did not miss anything. And let's talk about triangles now. Triangles. Triangle is a figure of three angles. And three sides respectively. This, for instance, is a triangle. Yes. This is a triangle. A, B, C. A, B, C. If A, B is not equal to B, C, and AB is not equal to AC, and AC is not equal to BC, this triangle is called scalene. So it's the most general triangle, yes? This is a generic triangle, not a special kind of triangle, yes? If two sides are congruent, if all three sides are congruent. The triangle is called equilateral. What else about triangles? Do they exist? Do isosceles equilateral triangles exist? Theorem. An equilateral triangle with any given side exists. This is actually the first theorem, I think, in the Elements by Euclid. Proof. Let A, this is A, be some segment. Then I will draw this segment. Segment A, connecting points A and B. Then I will take a compass which exists according to our compass postulate, And from point B, I will draw an arc of radius AB or A. Draw this arc. So every point on this arc lies at distance A from point B. Now from point A, I will draw an arc of radius AB. Oh, it's horrible. But it's because my board is so slippery. So from point A, I will also draw an arc of radius AB. Suppose it's a good arc. They intersect at some point C. So the distance from C to B is segment A. The distance from A to C by our construction is segment A. Yeah, it looks horrible, but we can pretend that all the segments are the same. Now it looks a little bit better. And that's why we have an equilateral triangle with each segment, the segment A, as every of the sides. Similarly, you can prove isosceles triangles exist. Right. And what else? Of preliminary notions. Preliminary notions. There are some important segments in triangles. Some important segments in triangles. What are these important segments? Well, this is a triangle ABC. You know, we have this result that you can draw perpendicular from any point on any straight line. This BD. BD is perpendicular to AC. Then BD is an altitude. How many altitudes we can draw in a triangle? Of course, we can draw three from every vertex. In some cases, you draw an altitude. It may fall not on the side, but on the extension of this side. So it will be B, A, C, and BD is still an altitude. Nothing is wrong with this. There is also a special segment called a bisector ABC, a segment that splits an angle at the vertex into two congruent parts, alpha, beta. Then this BE, alpha is congruent to beta, then BE is called a bisector. And of course you can draw a similar one from two other. If it exists, do bisectors exist? We will prove they do. And a similar story with another segment, A, B, C, that splits the opposite side into two congruent segments. I call it, must be straight line, of course. I will call it BM. And this segment is called BM, is called the median if AM is congruent to MC. Do medians exist? I think they do if segments have midpoints. Do segments have midpoints? Does every segment have a midpoint? We will prove they do. But we have to prove it. It doesn't follow from anywhere. Our segments are not on the number axis. Our segments don't have coordinates. We have to prove it using only the axioms that we believe hold. So we will continue next time with the most important topic. Congruence of triangles.